Hey there, fellow hackers. Have you ever wondered how cybercriminals manage to break into seemingly secure servers? Today we're going to pull back the curtain and show you exactly how these attacks work, not to cause harm, but to understand and prevent them. Welcome back to TechSky's Ethical Hacking 2024 series. Before we dive into today's technical journey, let me share something fascinating. Most successful server breaches don't come from sophisticated zero-day exploits or complex attack chains. Instead, they often exploit simple misconfigurations that administrators overlook. This insight is crucial because it means that understanding basic security principles is often more valuable than knowing advanced exploitation techniques. Before we begin, remember that these techniques should only be used in controlled, authorized environments like our lab. Using them against real targets without permission is illegal and unethical. In our last video, we set up our hacking laboratory with Kali Linux and Metasploitable. Today, we're going to use these tools to demonstrate a complete server-side attack chain, from initial reconnaissance to gaining root access. What makes this particularly interesting is that we'll be using techniques that remain relevant even in modern environments. Let's start by understanding our methodology. Think of a server attack like planning a heist in a movie. The first phase isn't picking locks or disabling alarms, it's reconnaissance. We need to understand what we're dealing with before we can exploit it. Think of this like a burglar examining a house. Before trying to break in, they first need to know where the doors and windows are. This process is called information gathering, and it's crucial for any successful attack. In technical terms, this means identifying running services, open ports, and potential vulnerabilities. In our case, we need to identify what services are running on our target server. First, let's get our environment ready. Open VirtualBox and locate both our virtual machines. Start Metasploitable first. This will be our target. Once it boots up, you'll see the login prompt. Enter msfadmin for both the username and password. Remember, Metasploitable is intentionally vulnerable, which is why we're using such simple credentials. Now we need to identify our target's IP address. Type ifconfig in the Metasploitable terminal. This command displays network interface information. Look under the ETS0 section for a netadr. This is our target IP address. Write this down carefully. It's like having the exact address of the building we're going to examine. Next, let's start our Kali Linux machine. After logging in with Kali as both username and password, we're going to use a powerful tool called Zenmap. Think of Zenmap as a sophisticated reconnaissance tool. It's like having X-ray vision for computer networks. It is the graphical interface for Nmap, one of the most powerful network scanning tools available. While many professionals prefer the command line version, Zenmap provides a more intuitive interface that helps us visualize our scan results better. It's particularly helpful when you're learning these concepts. And enter our target IP address in the target field. Before clicking scan, let's understand what's about to happen. Zenmap will send various types of packets to every possible port on our target machine. Each response, or lack thereof, tells us something about what services are running and potentially vulnerable. Click the scan button and watch as Zenmap begins discovering every open port and service on our target machine. This process might take a few minutes, but each piece of information it uncovers is potentially valuable for our attack. As the scan runs, let me explain what we're looking for. Every open port is like an open door or window in our house analogy. Some might be well secured, others might be practically inviting us in. We're particularly interested in ports running services that are known to have vulnerabilities or common misconfigurations. Let's examine our scan results. Look at port 21. This is running VSFTP 2.3.4, a file transfer service. Here's an interesting fact. This particular version actually shipped with a backdoor. This is like buying a house where the builder intentionally left a hidden entrance. When we Google VSFTP 2.3.4 vulnerabilities, we find numerous reports about this backdoor. But let's scroll down to something even more interesting, port 512. This is running NetKit RSH, and this is where things get really interesting. This service is like leaving your spare key under the doormat. It might be convenient, but it's terrible for security. While VSFTP 2.3.4 had a deliberate backdoor, NetKit RSH is vulnerable because of its inherent design philosophy. It comes from an era when the internet was a more trusting place, and its security model reflects that. To exploit this service, we need a specific tool, RSH client. It's not included in Kali by default, so we'll need to install it manually. Open Firefox and search for RSH client download for Kali Linux. Navigate to pkgs.org. You'll need to solve a captcha to access the download. Download the version for Debian. When your browser warns about the security risk, click Allow Download. We're knowingly downloading a security testing tool. Once downloaded, open the download directory and open the terminal here. We need root privileges for the installation, so enter sudo su and provide your password. Install the package using dpkg, I followed by the file name. Watch the installation progress. Any errors here could affect our attack success. Now comes the exciting part, the actual exploitation. We'll use the rolgin command, which is part of the RSH client package. The syntax is simple, rolgin lroot followed by the target IP. The lroot parameter is crucial. We're telling the service we want to log in, as the root user, which has complete system access. When we execute this command, something remarkable happens. We're granted immediate root access. No password required. This is the digital equivalent of walking up to a bank vault and having it swing open automatically. To verify our access, let's run some commands. Type ID to see our user context. Notice we have root, U80, privileges. Run uname to confirm we're on the target system. The output should match what we expect from our Metasploitable machine. This successful attack teaches us several critical lessons about system security. First, legacy services like rolgin often prioritize convenience over security. Second, default configurations are frequently insecure. Third, unnecessary services represent unnecessary risks. A service that isn't running cannot be exploited. In a production environment, preventing this type of attack requires a layered approach. Services like rolgin should be disabled entirely. They're relics of a bygone era. If legacy services must run, they should be protected by additional security measures like firewalls and proper authentication mechanisms. System administrators should regularly audit their systems for unnecessary services and ensure that required services are properly configured. Remember, understanding these attack techniques isn't about causing harm, it's about building better defenses. When you know how attackers think and operate, you're better equipped to protect systems against their techniques. That's all for today. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit that notification bell to catch our next video, where we'll dive even deeper into server-side attacks. I read every comment, so feel free to ask questions or suggest topics you'd like to see covered. Stay curious, stay ethical, and happy hacking.